On this video, I'll discuss some of my ideas regarding teaching on land. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications to know when the next video is about to come. If you like it, just give me a like on the like button and leave a comment on the comment section below if you want to know more about any subject in kitesurfing. Kiteboard teaching on land. The first steps of learning to kiteboard are usually done on land. In the first stage of kite discovery, we learn how to pilot the kite to understand where the pull is bigger or smaller. We are training and mapping our brain to react and control the kite according to the position of the kite in the wind window. Of course, this is easy in theory, but when it comes down to practice, this takes time to master. First, we need to discover this power and how to direct the kite to the place we want it to go. This is typically done with a small kite with low power. But this is where the problem begins. The power of the kite can be low due to little wind or due to the size of the kite and or lines. Some schools start with small foils, others with inflatables. Both are possible and okay, but they need to be adjusted to the wind power and conditions as they can still generate a lot of energy. The foil. The open cell foils usually are cheaper and more durable, but can't handle the water, unfortunately. I personally recommend the simple three-line kites for these first experimentations. They only need two commands, left and right, pulling on the bar, and have a third line that acts as a safety that is also used for rotation of the kite when it lands upside down, allowing for ease of use when teaching or learning how to pilot the kite. There is also closed cell kites that have already deep power capabilities that can be used on water, but these are more expensive and require two more commands, up and down by the center line. But this makes them similar to the kites you will use later on the water. The inflatable can be used on land, but it was designed for water. So besides being more expensive, it can break faster when used on land. Most of the times, it also needs four commands to control it. Left, right, up, and down, making it more difficult to pilot for the first phases. But here is where the problem most of the times begins. A lot of schools use small inflatables, 2-3 meters, up to 6-7 meters, considering this to be a safe practice as it's a small kite. But if it's proper wind and the pilot passes the kite in the power zone, the kite can generate a lot of pull and make you fly and fall. This can be diminished by using shorter lines, making the kite stay more on the edge of the wind window and avoiding that it goes too much into power zone. But the risk is still there. This makes the potential first experimentation with this kite become a bit of a problem when on land. There's a technique that can be used by instructors that makes sure the kite never goes into power zone. This technique uses a fifth line that the instructor has to control the kite position in the wind window and avoid the kite to go on the power zone. You can check it on the link provided above. The instructor needs to master this technique to be able to teach you safely. This technique, in combination with the short lines, is the way to make the land lesson with these kites completely safe. After the first experimentation and the student has mastered the two commands, left and right, with a foil kite, we need to introduce the other two, up and down, that allow the student to control the power of the kite in flight. So at this point, the usage of an inflatable becomes, in my opinion, possible if you are using it in short lines and with an instruction safety leash to be able to be close to the student for communication and for him to understand how to use the kite properly in a safe and controlled way. Common teaching power mistake. When teaching instructor candidates, I have noticed that most instructors feel the need to show the power of the kite to the student. And so a common exercise is to fly a kite in 8 figures, making it pass in the power zone all the time. This behavior can lead to accidents, especially if the power of the kite hasn't been appropriately tamed. The main thing students need to learn is how to park the kite. Moving can be done by accident. Making sure the kite stands still in one of the positions determined by the instructor is the problematic thing. Also, once on the water, this is what we need to do the most. Most of the times when you're riding, the kite is parked. Think about kite surfing, and when you realize, you pass most of the time riding and the kite is in a parked position, only moving it when there's a need of generating power and the movements are small. The other mistake is doing most exercises in a standstill position. If you look at kite surfing, it is not a standstill sport. Kite surfers have to move all the time, So training commands while standing still doesn't provide any proper evolution to the memory mapping and muscle training required to kitesurf. In fact, it's just mapping wrong sensations that later will delay the right learning. On land, we should mimic all that we do in the water. So moving in the same directions we do on water is the correct way of mapping the student's brain and muscles to what will happen ahead. So, if you're looking for a school or an instructor to learn how to kitesurf, take a look at the school's first lessons. Check if they use kites that don't generate power, small foils or inflators with short lines and instructor leash, or land. And also pay attention to the lesson type and if the student exercise leads them to move around simulating the water performance. This will enhance your learning curve. Search for an IKEA school that is listed in the IKEA website. Those are the only ones that ensure you will have an IKEA instructor and an IKEA course. Others may say IKEA course because they have one instructor that is IKEA, but it doesn't mean that that one will be your instructor. Check also for the school and instructor feedback on their IKEA page. Hope you liked this video, and I see you on the next one.